Listen for the words details and expose.
Just another ordinary school day. Students preparing for class to begin. Miss Davis writing on the board. Space monkey juggling a globe with his feet. Until...
Hi, I'm Rose Franklin. I'm the new girl at school.
Welcome to our school, Rose. We're so pleased to meet you.
Thank you, Miss Davis.
For now, let's have you sit next to Becky while I dig up some supplies for you.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. My name is Becky.
Oh. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Becky. Word down the street is you're sitting next to the new girl. Care to share any details about her?
If you want details, why not go straight to the source?
This is my friend Todd Ming. We call him Scoops.
That's right.
He writes for the school newspaper, The Daily Rag.
They call me Scoops. She said that.
Well, hi, Scoops. I'm Rose Franklin, and I just moved here from Freeport City. My dad worked at the pretzel factory there, but now he works at the pretzel factory in this city.
Thanks for the details. You really covered the who, what, where, when, and why. Maybe you could be a reporter like me someday.
Actually, I'm already a reporter. An investigative reporter.
An investigative reporter?
Yeah, that means I dig up clues and chase down leads. A regular reporter usually just types stuff up about normal, everyday stuff.
Uh-oh.
Rose, my nickname is Scoops because my stories expose new and important information. In the newspaper biz, we call that getting the scoop. If all I did was type stuff up, my nickname would be Type Stuff Up. But it isn't. My nickname is Scoops, as I believe I have mentioned.
Oh, no. I didn't mean to offend Scoops. I can tell by his questions. He's a good reporter.
Scoops is a good reporter and super friendly, so I don't think he'll stay mad. Just be careful you don't offend Jared over there. His nickname is Grudges.
Grudges.
Later.
I was thinking we should ask Rose to hang out with us this afternoon. What do you think?
Rose. I could call myself an investigative reporter if I wanted to. I just happen to have a different way of exposing the truth to my readers.
I'm sure she didn't mean to offend you. Let's give her another chance. Hi, Rose. We were wondering if you wanted to hang out with us today.
It'll probably be weird and boring and awkward, but if you still want to, that's fine.
Why would it be weird and boring and awkward?
Oh, no. He probably just means he doesn't know if we have anything in common.
Well, Scoops and I are both dedicated journalists, so we have that in common.
Oh, really? I thought I was just a crummy old type stuff up reporter.
Oh, all I meant by that was we probably have different ways we expose the truth to our readers.
We don't have anything in common. Business in town. If I can dig up enough details, I'll write an article about them for tomorrow's paper.
Looks like a new barber shop.
Oh no.
What?
I mean, oh, now. As in, oh, now I'll have some new hairstyles to choose from.
Strange. Does Becky always act funny like that?
Nah, it's nothing. And even if it is something, it's probably not a detail that's worth investigating. Should I try a buzz cut?
No.
Meanwhile, across town in the city's bustling light bulb district, the energy monster is going absolutely snap-happy.
What are we gonna do, Huggy?
A victory, Word Girl. Can I get a comment for the Daily Rag?
You sure can. How about, looks like the energy monster had an energy shortage?
Really? That's your comment?
No, of course not. I meant to say that, we really pulled the plug on the energy monster. Or something like that. I have to go.
Why?
I can't hear you. I'm flying away. Oh, hi, guys. What did I miss?
Why, you missed Word Girl shocking it to the energy monster.
I did?
No, you didn't.
Why do you say that?
Because you're Word Girl.
Wait, what? Word Girl!
Come on, Becky, the clues are everywhere. You look the same, you sound the same. Whenever Word Girl shows up, you disappear. You even both have a monkey sidekick.
Rose, I don't know how you got the idea that I'm Word Girl, but I'm telling you it's preposterous, absurd, ridiculous, foolish. I mean, no, that's not true.
Becky's right, Rose. You'd need a lot of details before you could possibly report a story like that.
What do you mean, details?
Details? Oh, details are all the small pieces of information that help us understand a bigger idea. Ugh, I walked right into that one.
All right, I'll get more details. And when I do, I'm going to expose Word Girl's secret identity.
What am I going to do, Scoops?
I know how you feel, Becky. I mean, Rose exposing the Word Girl story? Even though I knew the truth first? It's just not fair.
Without conveyor belts, we'll have to salt all the pretzels by hand.
All right, Sparky. Time to shut you down for good. Great, Rose. And she has a camera. The energy monster has never felt stronger. There's got to be a way we can slow her down. That's it, Huggy. Maybe some vigorous exercise will tire her out. Hey, Energy Monster!
Hi, Rose. Isn't it great to have a hero like Word Girl protecting the pretzel factory?
It sure is, Dad. But you're blocking my shot.
Thanks, Word Girl.
Come on, Huggy. Looks like the coast is clear.
Gotcha. And now I've got the proof I need to expose Word Girl.
Please, Rose, don't expose me. When you expose something, it means you uncover it and leave it without any protection. And I really don't want that to happen to Bob and me.
Well, I'm sorry, Becky, but the public has a right to know the truth. I've got the scoop, Scoops. All the important details are here, even pictures from the pretzel factory that will finally expose Word Girl's identity.
I've got to hand it to you, Rose. You're a great reporter.
Investigative reporter. Thanks.
You did miss one little detail, though. Word Girl is constantly putting herself in danger to protect our city. If the villains knew her secret identity, do you think they'd let her live a normal life?
Probably not, but...
And if it wasn't for Word Girl, your dad would be stuck at the pretzel factory salting pretzels by hand all day and night.
Okay, you've got a point. And I do appreciate everything Word Girl has done for the city and for my dad.
And don't forget what she's done for you.
For me?
Not Word Girl, Becky. She went out of her way to help you fit into a strange new place. She even got me to like you.
Really?
Yeah. Now this is your chance to do something nice for Becky.
I don't know. I still think a reporter should report the news no matter what. And Word Girl's secret identity is definitely news. I don't know what to do.
You've got 2 more hours until your deadline, so think about it. But I hope you decide on a story that will do the most good for our city.
The next day at school.
Extra! Shocking front page news!
Oh, I can't look. You do it, Bob. Oh, no! Rose did it! She exposed the new barbershop. Rose! You didn't expose my true identity. How can I ever thank you?
Thank Scoops. He helped me understand that keeping Word Girl's identity a secret is what's best for my new city and my new friend.
Oh, thanks, Rose.
Hey, Becky. Unnamed sources near the monkey bars are saying you're considering changing your hairstyle. Care to comment?
I just have one thing to say about that. The Daily Rag is the greatest newspaper on the planet!
Wow, that's a great quote! But what does it have to do with a new hairstyle?
Nothing, I guess. But if I ever do change my hair, I promise the Daily Rag will get the inside scoop.
Hey, that's great. I'm glad I won't have to change my nickname.
I'm glad, too. It's hard for me to remember new names. Oops. I probably shouldn't have exposed that detail about myself. And you probably should tune in next time for all the details on another thrilling adventure of... WordGirl!